Josh Poysden took 5 wickets to restrict Middlesex on day 1 at Edgbaston. 5th place Warwickshire hosted leaders Middlesex, and after Warwickshire's rain affected round 15 match against Durham had shown some positive signs for the hosts, they were looking to cause some problems for the Division 1 leaders. And so it proved almost immediately, with Robson out to the 8th ball of the day, caught at slip by Chopra off right for 1. 3 overs later and Middlesex were 2 down, Wright removing Gubbins for 2 with an excellent caught and bowled. Gubbins clearly believed the ball may have bounced before the Warwickshire quick scooped it off the turf, but he was eventually given his marching orders by umpires Milnes and Saggers. Middlesex were 6 for 2 and in desperate need of a partnership, and Malan and Compton delivered, putting on a further 71 runs prior to lunch without further loss. Malan came out fighting after the break, scoring boundaries on both sides of the wicket to take him past 50. However, he lost partner Compton with the score on exactly 100, caught by Chopra off right for 33. Eskenazi helped himself to a boundary off the first ball that he faced, and he continued to apply the pressure with boundaries off Patel and Wright in the following 4 overs. Malan was then out to Poysden midway through the session, caught by Clark for 57. Poysden had his second 4 overs later, Simpson outcaught Hain for 5. Franklin joined Eskenazi at the crease and the pair went about building a partnership through to tee, with both batsmen looking more comfortable against the spin of Poysden and Patel. However, with the last ball before the tee break, Poysden got one to grip in the rough and turned viciously, trapping Franklin LBW for 29. Middlesex 190 at the tee break. Poysden's spin continued to dazzle after the break. Eskenazi done by the flight, out bowled for 49. Rayner put on 12 before he fell in similar fashion, becoming Poysden's 5th wicket in the process. Roland Jones also made 12 before he was well caught at leg slip by Hain off the bowling of Patel. Podmore added some valuable runs alongside Patel for the 10th wicket. But he was the last man out not long before the end of play, caught by Clark off right for 21. Warwickshire negotiated 2 tricky overs before stumps without loss, but Bell was the happier of the 2 captains at the end of day 1, after bowling out the Division 1 leaders for 242. Middlesex missed the stability of George Bailey in the middle order, who was on 1-day international duty for Australia in Sri Lanka. Malan was the only batsman to pass 50, with the spin of Poysden doing most of the damage for the hosts. Warwickshire will resume on day 2 on 1 without loss.